I think what brought me to the research was the mystery of if the causes of gender equality have been really well researched, that is, if we know what the causes are, then why does it persist? And I think that's what brought me to the work of Pierre Bourdieu. And his work was around, you know, how does this stuff persist intergenerationally? And so then it was about solving a mystery. I think the other thing with my research is it's qualitative. That is, I go and speak to people. And so there's a richness that you get from that that's not in statistical data. You're hearing hundreds of stories. And then from when you see or hear consistency in one group, you know, women versus another group, you know, chairs of boards or CEOs or executive recruiters, you know, after you've spoken to, you know, several hundred, that there's some truth in there. You know, there's consistency that they're actually pointing to the very issues that continue, that allow this to persist. What it also does is allows you to then identify, well, what are the things we need to change? So again, coming back to Pierre Bourdieu, I think what we have in Australia is a cultural problem, and we need to tackle that rather than, you know, focus on the symptoms. The pay gap blows my mind. The fact that, and it's very simplistic to say that men and women get paid differently for the same work. You know, it would be, you'd be hard pressed to find an organisation where a manager has deliberately done that. That's not the case. But it's holistically, there are factors that women face that men don't, that actually bring about the same result. So while it's not an individual making a decision necessarily, although it does happen, it's a societal outcome where women are on average paid less than men. So that blows my mind that, okay, as a society, we need to own that. I think the second one, and this is really important for Australia's ability to compete with the rest of the world, given that we're a small country, we have to be smart in what we do, is that our best and our brightest, you know, women are out not leading our major corporations. That kind of brain power and creative talent we absolutely need driving corporate Australia. And I think the third thing is our House of Representatives and our Senate don't represent the makeup of the Australian population, and that's appalling. There need to be far more diverse groups represented in Parliament, and particularly more women in Parliament, both federal, state and local. Catherine Fox, and it was again at a Women in Leadership conference, would have been a few years ago, said that she thought that the gender pay gap represented a financial version of all of the elements confronting women. I think it's a really clever way of looking at it. It's a financial representation of gender inequality. So to the extent that I'm talking about that unexplained bit not being explained by position in industry or position in hierarchy, really it is. If you eliminate those three things that I spoke about, what's left is the sum total of all of the unconscious bias, discrimination, you name it, all of the things that women confront that men don't. That's that unexplained bit. So it's explained holistically, but not in individual, you know, dollar terms. I think that's the biggest challenge. If you're wanting to solve gender equality, then gender is it's on a spectrum, but if you just look at sex, it's men and women. If half the population aren't even aware of the problem or aren't even willing to address it, and I don't think it's a lack of willingness, I think genuinely it's a lack of understanding. I think most Australians would say we pride ourselves on a fair go. We really believe in equality. I personally think that if we could get our education better. And that question from the floor was a great one about the role that government doesn't seem to be taking up is educating the Australian public about this issue and creating a sense of awareness. I think if most people understood the inequities around leadership, around representation, around pay, really understood them, there'd be a lot more being done. And by its nature, it would involve men and women equally. Absolutely. If you were to, and I don't think it's just men, to be honest. I mean, I work in schools, you know, I've interviewed graduates. They, for the most part, believe, well, haven't we solved this? You know, wasn't it solved last century? You know, and I think it comes as a surprise, not just to men, but to many women as well, that these problems exist. And until confronted with the issues around childcare and then what that means for career and sharing of roles, until you're confronted with that, it's not reality, it's something that others have to worry about. So until people really understand what all of that's about, yeah, we're going to have that problem getting engagement. So we set out after the Filling the Pool report to practice what we preach. That is, you know, if these changes are not going to come about by incremental initiatives, we have to do something serious, we have to do something big. So the idea was floated. The Australian Institute for Business and Economics funded a two-day workshop we brought together. We went online and we found as many industry bodies whose sole job it is to represent women in that particular sector. And we ended up with 36, mainly women, but there were a few guys in the room, but mainly women, to discuss, okay, we know there's all of these initiatives going on. There are lots of them out there. They don't seem to be getting traction. So what do we do? How are we going to be different? What is it that we want to achieve? And it was a pretty serious, full-on, really hard 2 days of discussion, you know, what is it that we're trying to do? And ultimately, there was consensus around the fact that we have to tackle the cause, not the symptoms. And the cause is, and we hear it over and over and over, is it's cultural. There's a way we do things in Australia that has to change if we're going to see change in the outcomes. So our approach to childcare, our approach to flexibility, all of those kinds of issues are cultural, at their root are cultural issues. So we set out to create an organisation whose job it is to engage with the Australian people around our culture and its need to change.